Andariki Namaskaram. Andhra Pradesh has been in the forefront on numerous occasions and has produced some of the greatest thinkers, writers, statesmen, and leaders with a great vision and foresight. All the 13 districts of the state have their unique identity and are also bonded with a common thread of language and oneness of the culture. Telugu and Telugu culture is not new to me, as we are neighbors. We have recently celebrated Jagannath Rath Jatra at Puri. Yesterday, I was at Tirupati to seek the blessings of Lord Balaji. And today, I am at the abode of Ma Kanakadurga. The divine blessings are always there for us. And I hope the state of Andhra Pradesh, which has its own ups and downs, will settle down soon and move ahead towards development and prosperity. At the outset, I congratulate the young Chief Minister, Sri V.S. Jagan Mohan Reddy Garu, on his stupendous victory, and I am told that he is working on a new concept called social engineering by setting the priorities on a mode that reaches the intended sections in the most effective manner. I am glad to hear about the approach and the Padajatra or mass contact program which he had undertaken, covering the length of the state and interacting with the people of all sections and recording their grievances, and from the accumulated plight of the people, he had drafted the Navaratnas or nine gems, which formed the main part of his election manifesto that gave him a decisive verdict. I am told that his vision of providing quality Medicare to every citizen, irrespective of caste, class, creed, or political affiliation, was an improvised version of similar schemes which were launched by his father, late Dr. V.S. Rajasekhar Reddy Garu, who has inspired the entire nation by his flagship welfare schemes. Education is the other field which the young Chief Minister is laying more focus on and derived methodology to improve literacy rates on the hand and improve the quality of government schools on the other, giving incentives to the mother for sending her two children to school will be a boon to the poor households, and it will be a stepping stone for a great socio-economic change that would be assured in with passage of time as the scheme gets underway and sinks into system, bringing desired results. Besides providing incentives to the mother to send the children to school, the scheme will also eliminate social evils like child labor and improve the literacy rates. I am told that the scheme will be in force until the child clears class 12 or intermediate, and the fees reimbursement will take care of the educational needs of the child thereafter for professional courses and higher studies. Treating the money spent on the education as a capital expenditure is something which needs to be appreciated, as very few people may think in those terms, as the results may take long time, say 15 years or more, from the day of joining school to coming out of professional colleges. But it is money well spent and wisely spent, as it will transform the society by many nudges. I am told agriculture is a prioritized area and farmers' welfare is high on the government agenda, right from providing seed capital to quality seeds, fertilizers and pesticides, and assuring market price is a great thing for the farming community. Besides disbursing social security pensions, the state government has taken up a bold step for decentralization of administration by setting up village secretariats and appointing village volunteers who will deliver the government schemes at the doorsteps of the villagers. The bond of culture and heritage always keeps people happy, and after having a darshan of Lord Balaji at Tirupati, I am here in the heartland of Ma Kanakadurga, and I pray to them to bestow their blessings on the state to progress and prosper, overcoming all shortcomings. It is highly embarrassing for me that some person started addressing me as His Excellency or Mahamahim, since the date of my appointment as the Governor of Andhra Pradesh. This creates a barrier between me and the people. From the very beginning of my political career, I have been serving the people in different capacities. I am a proud Indian, and as Governor of Andhra Pradesh, I am not only the first citizen of the state, I am the first servant of the people. I therefore very earnestly appeal to all concerned for not addressing me as His Excellency or Mahamahim. I am deeply committing myself to serve the people of Andhra Pradesh and extend all my cooperation for the overall development of the state. Jai Hind.